force applied is 0, then dl by dt will be equal to 0, which indicates that the angular momentum is going to be constant, which is nothing but indirectly your law of conservation of moment, angular momentum, which can be written as L as I omega is constant, or you can write I1 omega 1 equal to I2 omega 2 equal to so on. Clear? And what can be the statement? Similar statement. In an isolated system, net angular momentum is always conserved. Clear? Well, now, once if you apply on this exactly, you'll get sometimes a very simple question. I'll just show you here. So what they do is, they'll give a question like, you're having this as your earth of mass m and radius r is there. If suppose already if it is rotating with angular velocity omega 1, so what is omega 1 you are having? 2 pi by 20, t. That is nothing but 24 hours, what you are having right now, okay? Your earth completes one rotation in 24 hours. So t1 you are having is what? 24 hours. Since it is an objective question, you can keep the data in terms of hours itself. They'll ask you, suppose suddenly this earth is going to shrink to half of its radius, okay? Then what happens to the time period? What happens to the, it's simple. So it is suddenly shrinking. No one is applying the external force. Since you are having external torque as zero, then what should be there? I1 omega 1. This is very commonly asked question for you. I1 omega 1 should be equal to I2 omega 2. What is I1 omega 1 you are having? What is I1 is there? I1 is nothing but we are having it as, since it is a solid sphere like, our formula comes as NU 2 by 5 cancels m into r square into, before we had 2 pi by t1, right? Later, this becomes again a solid sphere only, mass there is no change. But what they again? There is no change in mass. They are saying that if Earth is going to shrink suddenly to half of its radius size. So half of the radius size means nu. R2 is going to be how much now? It becomes as R by 2 square. R by 2 square. That becomes R square by 4 into. So obviously the time period is going to change. If you make this, so all these things are going to cancel. So what is left now? You are having is just 4 times T2 will be equal to what? T1. Okay, therefore T2 becomes what? T1 by 4. That is going to be 24 hours by 4. Means it is going to complete now one rotation within 6 hours. Okay. No, don't break your head. When 24 hours is there, then also it is not possible for us to cover the what? Prepare for the NEET or JEE. Then think, if only 6 hours is there, what all you are going to do within that? Okay. And we'll see when it shrinks. Okay. Well, let's come back to the previous examples where I had, okay, this we had done. Well, this one, let us come back for this, some examples on the angular momentum and the torque. So on the angular momentum, so do remember what I said, you can use either, while calculating angular momentum, you can use either r perpendicular into the momentum, or you can use r into a momentum vector, okay, component perpendicular to the position vector. Now here is your question. You are projecting a ball of mass, say some 100 gram, with velocity 20 meters per second. Okay. With velocity 20 meters per second at an angle of, say, 60 degrees. 60 degrees, okay. The question is, about the point of projection, what will be the angular momentum of the ball when it is at its highest point? See, once you know the concept of angular momentum, they start clubbing your different topics. Here we are clubbing the angular momentum as well as what? The two-dimensional motion, projectile concept. See, what is our requirement? R perpendicular into P or R into P perpendicular. Okay. Now, this also we can calculate easy because this is R by 2, this is height. Even this position vector can be found. Choice is yours. Okay. Or what we can do? Anyway, when it is at the highest point, it will be having what? Its momentum only along the x direction, means horizontal direction, which is given by m into, we are having ux. That becomes how much? M into, m is nothing but 100 gram is there. So we'll calculate later. Right now we'll keep it as it is. M into ux is there. Okay. And I need to find r perpendicular for this. Even that can be easily found because you are going to have, if I produce this in the backward direction, so this is the direction of your momentum, then from here what I should find? A perpendicular distance to the what? Momentum. So this itself becomes your perpendicular distance you are going to have, because this is perpendicular. This is R perpendicular what you are going to find. So what is R perpendicular? So R perpendicular is nothing but our height of the projectile, maximum height of the projectile, which also you know to calculate. How will you calculate? U square sine square theta divided by 2 times g. See, all the datas are available for you. Then what is going to be your angular momentum? So just get calculated. It becomes what? R perpendicular into P, and R perpendicular we have got as height, that is U square sine square theta divided by 2G into, what is the momentum you have got? M into UX, which is nothing but M U cos theta, right? M U cos theta. Further, you'll simplify yourself, okay, as I may be running out of time, okay. So, further, hope you can simplify this one, okay. So, we'll continue. Next. Suppose here is one more question with a translatory motion of a particle itself. So, what they are given is, a particle of mass, again 100 gram, is moving with velocity 20 meter per second with a constant velocity along a path. This is a path given for you. Along a path given by y equal to x plus 2. Now I can write the same thing as what? Y equal to mx plus c form. If I write like this, what the slope you are having? 1. Means the tan theta equal to what? 1 is there. That indicates what? Theta equal to your got as 45 degrees. Okay, one thing is clear. Then how your particle is moving? Making an angle 45 degrees with the x axis. So imagine this is moving like this. This is moving along this path where it is making an angle of what? 45 degrees with the what? Degrees with the horizontal. Fine. Now this is the direction of its velocity vector. This is the direction of its velocity vector. Its mass is given for you. And intercept is how much is given? 2. Means this should be how much? This should be how much? This should be on the y-axis, this is supposed to be 2. It's this distance we are having is 2. Again, I can think of same thing. If you want to find the angular momentum about the point O, you have to find. About this, you have to find. So L about O you want to find means, I can use R perpendicular into P here. If V is this, even the momentum is in the same direction, what you should do then? Just produce the momentum in the line of action of momentum in the what? Opposite direction, and get the perpendicular distance. So what is the perpendicular distance? So this is actually position vector, but R perpendicular from the momentum direction I am going to draw. So this becomes your R perpendicular. This is your R perpendicular. How will you find R perpendicular? Now what about this angle you are going to have? If this is 45 angle, then even this is going to be how much? 45 degrees. 45 degrees, because you are going to have, if I produce this back, so just here I can take, this becomes 45. If this is 45, this is 45. If this is 45, this is already 90. This is also how much we are having is 45 degrees. So this much is 2, and I need to find this perpendicular distance. This angle is 45 degrees. So R I have to find. It becomes what? So we are having is, this is going to be equal to R by 2 equal to sine of 45 or cos of 45, one of the same. Cos of 45. Therefore, this is going to be R becomes equal to what? 2 by root 2. This is 1 by root 2. That gives you what? Root 2 distance. Okay. So fill here then. This is root 2 meter into momentum. You can find from here. M into what? V there. So this becomes root 2 into mass is given as 0.1 kg. Velocity is 20. This 0, this is cancelled. You got as 2 root 2. What will be the unit of this? MVR. Okay. That is kg. Kg are having kg meter square per second. Okay. So kg meter square per second. Okay. M meter per second. One more R. Okay. So just get it. Okay. Hope it is clear. So let us see that how you are going to work out with the torque. Here is a bar we are having. So these concepts becomes important for you to start with your torque. Here is one, I have a linear bar. Say of mass M is there. And this is already is having a hinge over here, means fixed over here. Fixed over here. And the other end of this particular bar is suspended using one string. This is nothing but string we are having. If it is uniformly dense, where should be its mass weight acting? Weight should act through its center of mass, that is mg. One force is acting here. Due to the weight, there comes a tension in the string. Your question may be to find tension in the string. Your question may be to find if suppose suddenly the string is going to cut, what will be the angular acceleration of this particular bar? Okay, so different questions may come right now. So let us, equilibrium concept we will work out tomorrow. So let us now just find what will be the angular acceleration, the moment string is going to cut. The moment string cuts, okay, you need to find what will be the what? Angular acceleration. Okay, how you are going to find? The moment it cuts, then only one force is acting here, which is going to give a rotational effect for this. This is going to move in the, okay, in the clockwise direction due to what? Mg. The moment this cuts, it starts rotating like this about this hinge. Point P you can call. So what will be the torque produced by the Mg we are having? So torque produced is nothing but, we have it as the R cross P, or what I had told, you can use R, sorry, you can use R perpendicular into the what? Sorry, R cross F. So R perpendicular into F you can use. Now what is R perpendicular you are having? What is R perpendicular you are having? R perpendicular is nothing, but this is your F. This is your force acting. Then R perpendicular from the axis of rotation. This becomes your axis of rotation about which the rod is going to rotate. Okay. So this distance becomes your R perpendicular. So how much is R perpendicular? If I again suppose length of rod as 2 meter you can take, then this becomes 1 meter into mg. Mg. So we got already the torque as this much. Okay, not necessary to go for, if you want, you can take M as 1 kg. This became how much? This became 10 Newton meter, FR, Newton meter. Now, but my question is to find what? My question is to find alpha, okay? So, but remember, the same torque we know you want to calculate as I alpha. Now, equate these both. Okay, so already torque we have got. How much is there? 10 is there. What is moment of inertia of this? You are going to have moment of inertia depends on the what? Axis of rotation. About which it is rotating. Now, axis of rotation is what? Passing through the end of the rod. If it is through end of the rod, what is our formula we are having? 1/3 of ml square. Use it, okay? So we are having 1/3 of ml square into alpha. Just fill, that's all. 1/3 is 1/3. Mass we are having is 1 kg itself. L square becomes 4 into alpha. So we are going to have alpha as the 30 divided by 4 radian per second square. This is going to be your alpha. Okay. Hope all the things are clear for you. So tomorrow we are going to continue with the rolling motion. So off only. We make use of this relation. Remember, we use torque equal to I alpha. And one side we can use R cross F, means RF sine theta concept. One side we can use I alpha concept. This is off only we are going to make use of if required. Sometimes we are going to convert alpha as in terms of the what? Because we are having A equal to alpha. This alpha can be written as further A divided by the R also in the rotational motion. Depends on your situations, but these are the relations what you are going to have. Okay, hope all the things are clear about angular momentum as well as torque today. If any doubts are there, so you can just post in your WhatsApp groups. And tomorrow we are going to continue with the rolling motion, the other 2 days. So even tomorrow we try to cover the simple concepts. Inline log are there. So directly I'll give for the power and the work done in your rotational motion so that we can go for the 2 days for paper discussions. Okay. Thank you, children. Thank you for joining. Good day.